Today we will discuss few more questions of exercise 11.1. In my last video, we have already discussed question number 1 and question number 2. Question number 3. A train travels a distance of 165 km between two stations in 10 minutes. Okay? Distance covered by the train is this and the time taken by it is 10 minutes. Determine speed of the train in kilometer per hour. We have to change this means minute, time is given in minute. You have to find out the speed in kilometer per hour. So how we will do? First of all, we will write what is the distance. Distance is 165 kilometer and time is 10 minutes. So as we know that we have to find out the speed in kilometer per hour, so definitely we need to change this minute into hour. So let's change 10 minutes, 10 divided by 60 to change into hour, 1 by 6 hour. We have changed this time into hour. Now speed of the train in kilometer per hour is equal to, we know speed is equal to distance by time. So distance we will write up 165 and divided by time. Time you can see we have already changed this into hour. So we will put this time only 1 by 6. So 165 into reciprocal of this 6 by 1. You will multiply this, we will get 990 km per hour. This is the speed in km per hour. Next question, you have to find out the time taken to cover a distance of 495 km. Means you have to find out the time. And we know time is equal to distance by speed. We will put this distance and speed we will put this one only, which we have taken out in the first. So time is equal to distance by speed. So distance 495 as given in the question and speed, this is speed which we have just now taken out, 990. You will cancel this out, we will get 495 2 times 990. 1 by 2 hour is the time. Okay. Now question number 4. A person travels a total distance of 360 km by a car. He covers the first half at a speed of 60 km per hour. Means first half of the distance. Means this is the total distance. Okay. And it's half he has covered in this speed, 60 km per hour. First of all, tell me what is the half of this distance. So we will divide this by 2 to take out the half. So if you will divide it by 2, what we will get? 200 to 28 just 16. 180 km is the first half distance which is covered by in this speed. And the other half he has covered at this speed. Okay. So 180 is the first half and another 180 will be the second half. He has covered the first half with this speed and the second half with this speed. We have to find the total time taken to complete the entire journey. So total time taken means time is equal to what is distance by speed. So distance you know that is 360 km and speed you know this 2 speed. So we will not add this 2 speed to take out the total speed. But we need to find out the separate speed for each half, first half and the second half, just like this. Total distance is equal to 360 km. So first half, first of all find out 360 divided by 2. That is 180 km is the first half. Second half distance is another 180 km. We will find out the time for the first half. Okay. First of all, time taken for first half is equal to what? Distance by speed. So distance is 180. First half distance is 180 and first half speed is given, that is 60 km per hour in your question only. So we will write here speed. Okay. Means distance by speed because we are taking out the time. So time is equal to distance by speed. Distance and speed we have put. Now if you will cancel it, this we will get 3 hour. Time taken for the second half. Second half is that only 180 km. And second half speed is also given in the question, that is 45 km per hour. If you will cancel out this, we will get 4 hour. So first half he has completed in 3 hour and second half he has completed in 4 hour. So what is the total time for this, for him to complete the journey? That is 3 hour plus 4 hour, that is equal to 7 hour. Okay. And B number, average speed you have to find out in this. And average speed formula, average speed is equal to total distance covered by total time taken. So total distance we know that is 360 kilometer given in your question only, and total time. So total time we have taken out right now, that is 7 hours. Okay, for first half and second half, that is 7 hours. So this will not get cancelled. So we will change this into mixed fraction. 51, 3 by 7. You can divide this and change this into mixed fraction. 7, 5, 35. We will get here 10. And 7, 1, 7. We will get here 3. This is remainder. It will go up. And 51 will come here. And this one divisor will be as it is. Okay. I hope you have understood question number 4. Now question number 5. A truck travels some distance at a speed of 35 km per hour in 120 minutes. Truck travels some distance with this speed and with this time. And the remaining distance at a speed of 48 km per hour in 90 minutes. Means whatever the remaining distance he has covered in this speed and he has taken this much time to cover that. Determine the total distance covered. We have to find out the total distance, student. So distance is equal to, you know, speed into time. Okay. Distance is equal to speed into time. And we have the speed and we have the time for the first journey he has completed. And for the second remaining also, we have speed and we have time. So what we will do here, we have to find out the distance. So first of all, we will write the first speed and the second first speed and first time which we have taken to complete. So speed is given 35 km per hour and 120 minutes. You can see here it is given in kilometer per hour and this is in minutes. So you have to change this minute into hour. Okay, unit should be same. So how to change minute into hour? 120 by 60 divided by 60. So we will cancel this out. We will get here 2 hours. Now distance traveled for the first speed and first time. Okay, so the speed into distance is equal to speed into time. Speed is this, 35 km per hour, and time is this. So we will multiply, we will get 70 km is the distance. Now second, another speed is given for the remaining distance, that is 48 km per hour, and for this time is also given 90 minutes. So we will change again this minute into hour by dividing it by 60. So 3 by 2 hour. Now again the remaining distance will be speed into time. So speed 48 and time 3 by 2 hour. If you will cancel this, we will get 24 into 3, that is 72 km. For the first half journey 70 km and the second 72. Total distance will be what? This plus this, 70 plus 72 will be equal to 142 km. Next is asking average speed over the entire journey. So whenever the average speed is asking in the question, we know the formula, average speed is equal to total distance by total time. And we know what is the total distance, 142. Right now we have taken out 142 km, and total time. So total time you have to find out, a student. That is 2 hour and 3 by 2 hour. We will add this 2 hour and 3 by 2 hour. We will get 7 by 2 hour. Okay, that is 120 minutes and 90 minutes equal to 7 by 2 hour. Okay, now total distance is this, total time we will put 7 by 2. Now just write its reciprocal, 142 into 2 by 7, we will get this 44 by 7 kilometer per hour is the average speed. Okay, question number 5 we have done. Now question number 6 and 7 I will give you homework, because question number 6 you can do. Understand it, a bus covers a total distance of 740 km. This is the total distance, okay? And out of which it covers 156 km at this speed and 146 km at this speed. And it covers the remaining distance in 5 hours. Determine the speed of bus to cover remaining distance. So speed we can find out. Speed is equal to distance by time. But remaining distance we have to find out. So what will be the remaining distance? Look at here. This is the total distance, 740. Okay. What you have to do to find out the remaining distance? Add this two distance, 156 and 156 and 146. This two distance you will add and subtract from this total distance. We will get the remaining distance. Okay, so remaining distance by time taken. So time taken is already given, that is 5 R. You will put and find out the answer. Speed is equal to distance by time. Next is average speed of bus for the whole journey. Average speed means total distance covered by total time taken. So total distance is this 740, and total time will be what? Total time means you have to find out the time for this first half. One time is equal to what? Distance by speed. You will find out the time for this, and again you will find out the time for this also, distance by speed. And at last you will add this 5 hour in that. You will get the total time, and total distance is already given, that is 740. Okay. Question number 7 also, try it, you can do it. It is very simple question. Question number 8, find the distance covered by a bike in 4 minutes at a speed of 63 km per hour. You have to find out the distance. So to find out the distance, we need speed and time, and speed and time both is given. This is the speed and this is time. But you just see that time is given in minutes. So you have to change this minute into hour, because speed is given in kilometer per hour. Just like this. Speed is 63 km per hour and time is 4 minutes. So we will change this minute into hour. 4 by 60 divide by 60, 2 by 30. And again if you will cancel it, we will get 1 by 15 hour. Okay. Now distance covered by bike is equal to speed into time. So speed we will put this one and time this. Or you will multiply this, and if you will divide it by 15, we will get 4.2 km. See, 15 4 just 60, we will get 3. Decimal if you will put, we will get here 30. 15 2 just 30. 4.2 km you will get the distance. Okay. So this exercise is finished. Next day we will start the exercise 11.2. But you have to complete question number 6 and 7 by yourself. Okay.